Welcome everyone. In this video I am going to discuss application to the Boston Home Mortgage Disclosure Act data using Stata. So you can download this data from Stock and Watson Introduction to Econometrics Chapter 11. You can download the do file of Stata from the same place. So there are variables which we have discussed in previous video and also use in this video while applying through Stata: payment income ratio, house expense to payment income ratio, loan to value ratio, personal credit history, loan to value ratio if greater than 80%, greater than 95%, less than 80%, and similarly there are financial variables like, as I mentioned, mortgage credit score, public bad credit score, consumer credit score. There are some other variables like self-employed, single, high school diploma, unemployment. And in this video, I am going to construct these six columns using Stata, and we try to find out this final row, that how do a person having all values at average, but if he is black, will be denied loan, versus if all these values are at average and person is white. That's what I am going to do using Stata. So please be with me. We have this Stata do file. You can download it from Stock and Watson, and I am going to construct these variables using these commands which are given in this do file. So you can, up to this, I am going to just run these selected commands. So now you see, we want to calculate the probability that a person who is black will be denied loan, probability that person is white denied loan, for given value of payment income ratio. For this, more on this, you can watch previous video. So I am going to use here, one way is use data hand calculator, and you create here coefficients, and then so the payment income ratio, and multiply it with average value, black, one constant, and all that. Another very simple way is in Stata is to calculate, is to use command margins. Margins at black equal 1, and at means you are using payment income ratio average. So the person who is black will be denied loan, 25% probability that he will be denied loan. And now if the same person is white, will be denied loan, 0, and you will have 8% chances that person is denied loan with white race, with same with average that is 0.33 payment income ratio is 0.087, and the difference between these two you may call it is racial discrimination. But it's too early to jump at this result, because there are so many other variables like consumer credit score, your public bad credit record, your employment level, your marital status, and other demographic social variables. So I'm going to basically run some more commands here to calculate, to include those variables. So we have constructed some more variables here. We have constructed, okay, before I go to that, please, how do we calculate these marginal plots as well? So you can use margins at black equal 1. Payment income ratio for different values, payment income ratio at various values equal to, let's 0.1, and we take a gap of 0.11 up to 0.9. So, and now we calculate margins plot. So you see here you have a plot and with confidence interval, lower the loan value ratio, lower the probability that you will be denied loan. Higher the loan value ratio, payment income ratio, higher the probability you will be denied loan. But now we compare it with white, and you see this confidence interval, this value is 0.8, this is 0.9, this is 0.7, this is 0.6, this is 0.4 against these payment income ratios. Means these are the probabilities on vertical axis that you will be denied loan, though you observe always 0 or 1, but we calculate these probabilities. Now let's do the same thing for white race and just replace black equal to 0 and just run this margin commands again. So you see this graph is different than the previous one. So it shows that there is difference between black and white loan approval and denial rates. But there are so many other variables which can be potential omitted variables. So we need to include those variables in our model. So to include those variable models, we calculate all these variables. And we generate these variables. You can please go through those Stock and Watson data. And one way of calculating these predicted probabilities is to use this scalar. This you see black zero payment income ratio with average 0.33, and then next coefficient with average value, next coefficient with average value. So you calculate these probabilities, predicted probabilities, by using this procedure, and I am going to use it. Do the same with scalar. So this comes out to be 0.060. But if you use the margin command, that is very simple. Margins at black equal 1 at means, all other values are at means. So you see this is 0.1307, which is the same here, 0.1307, which is 0.1307. And similarly, if you calculate it margins 0, so it will be 0.07, the same as we have, and the difference between these two will be .0604, which we have displayed in our final row of table as I have shown you in PowerPoint slides. So similarly, you can use other commands as well, and at the moment I am going to just for each model I am using ESTSTO, that helps me at the end to generate all these regression models in tabular form. This is your column 3 of PowerPoint and table 2, chapter 11 of Stock and Watson. You can run this all this. I am not very much concerned about this. So again, you see, instead of calculating all this using this very long formula by using data other utilities, just go to statistics, post estimation results, and calculate marginal means, marginal effects, and or use the command directly. You can use here command margins and all that, which I have explained. You can make a margin plot with confidence intervals, margins plots without confidence intervals. That depends what is your requirement. So final is, now we are going to generate these six columns in tabular form, ESTTAB, and so these are your six columns which I have shown you. So in this case, what do we say? And we have the final row which we have to calculate for each one separately. For this one is simple, this linear probability model, 8% is the difference between black and white. This is not 0.688, but you have to calculate it by margins, black equal to 1, other values at mean, and black equal to 0, other values at mean. This is payment income ratio, 4.7, this is 0.449, Here you have to calculate, basically these will be used as you have to use logistic function. For this you have to use normal distribution function. Here you, these four are just variations of model 3. So these coefficients don't interpret it directly. Okay, one more thing. You can also use calculate if you use logistic. If you use the command logistic, that is, if you use logit deny black PIRAT robust standard errors. So this is the case. If you want to calculate odds ratio, use logistic logit. Okay, let's repeat the same command instead of writing all. Just you can use here OR. So now you have odds ratios. Now you have odds ratios. Or you can use logistic. Here you can use logistic. So again you have odds ratios here with robust standard errors. So it depends that, and what are odds? Odds are basically probability of P over divided by 1 minus P. And then you can calculate the ratios. You can work with that. I hope you have got the main point that how you can calculate logit, probit and linear probability model. How do we compare it for Boston data? And above all, using margins command is very useful for calculating predicted probabilities in this logistic model or probit model. Thank you for watching. Take care.